evening, Truth Seekers. Mike Malloy here. Welcome to tonight's program. If you, how about these crazy right-wingers, huh? Oh, my God. It just never stops. I don't know why we focus so much attention on these freaks. I really don't. But I guess because they're in their little neo-fascist way trying to destroy the country. And, you know, starting with the Mitster all the way down to the little bloggers and the little, you know, column writers. Poison, poison, poison. Well, okay, that's cool. We're not going to focus a lot on the cretins tonight at all. Why bother? However, I got this thing from, it came from Bob Patterson, but it's about a guy named James Richard Armstrong. He has worked in the kitchen at Occupy Oakland, and he is an online columnist. And he has an idea that I think makes a lot of sense. Let me back up a little bit. Remember when the phony reports of phony violence, the only violence perpetrated against Occupy people were violence by the police, or perpetrated around the Occupy movement were violence perpetrated on them by the police. There are a couple of instances of people not even associated with that who got in some kind of trouble. I don't know. But the right-wing cockroaches, you know, immediately jump up and start screaming, "Shut them down! They're becoming dangerous!" That was what all these right-wing turkeys decided to say. Well, James Richard Armstrong has an idea, and there's something here. He thinks, using the very same logic, that all Christian colleges should be shut down. All of them. Because look what happened in Oakland just the other day. I mean, same place, Oakland, same place where incident occurred in Oscar Grant Plaza during the Oakland Occupy movement. And a young guy was killed, had nothing to do with Occupy. But you heard the screaming and the shrieking and the frothing at the mouth and the spittle flying all over the place from the right wingers. Shut it down! Shut it down! It's dangerous! Well, okay, apply the same logic. Seven people systematically shot and murdered at a Christian nursing college campus. So James Richard Armstrong is suggesting that these cesspools of murder and violence be shut down. Don't you agree? The Occupy Oakland situation, there was one shooter and one victim. But at the Christian Nursing College in Oakland, one shooter and seven victims, as well as people injured. So, shut it down! They're becoming dangerous! Right? And, as James Richard Armstrong II goes on, since Christians have a propensity for violent acts all around the world, shouldn't that be even more of a reason to shut it down? As James Richard Armstrong II writes, history is chock full of circumstances where Christians are systematically murdering people who don't agree with their particular brand of illness. Therefore, there is precedence for this group of closed-minded thinkers of violence. So the recent attack on unarmed fellow students shouldn't be all that shocking, right? The Ku Klux Klan is a Christian organization. Those in the mountains of northern Idaho, with their little hidey holes and their automatic weapons, they're Christians too. And as Armstrong goes on, however, since Christians control anything, they've spun things to fit their evil agenda. Anytime one of them gets loose and nuts up and kills somebody, they always trot out that it was merely an isolated incident. And that may be true with some of this stuff. But you can't play that card every time and expect someone with unencumbered independent thought to buy it. Well, James Richard Armstrong goes on here. It's a very interesting piece, and it's very lengthy. But I think he makes his point right at the beginning. All the screaming and frothing at the mouth, that is typically right-wing. I mean, it doesn't make any difference if they're bloggers or talk show hosts or on TV or radio or on the Internet. It doesn't make any difference. They all follow the same script. They all are on the same page. Everything is exactly the same. There's no variation, no deviation, except in their minds, which are totally deviant. So using their same sick, twisted, disgusting logic, quote, quote, then it stands to reason that if one person is shot dead, an outside incident near an Occupy Oakland situation, encampment, and on the other end, the screams come to shut it down, they're getting violent, shut it down, then one shooter going on a campus and murdering seven people, a Christian college campus, murdering seven people and wounding more, God knows how many he wounded psychologically, shouldn't that be shut down too? Now, come on, you little right-wing turds, come on, come on, come on, you know what I'm talking about, come on, admit it, admit it. You know, if I ever hear a right-winger admit anything that's based in logic, common sense, decency, justice, fair play, logic, did I already say logic? I will immediately fall down on my knees, raise my hands to the heavens, and start screaming, thank Jupiter, thank Jupiter, thank Jupiter. Hey, Mitt Romney, oh, by the way, this hour is being sponsored by, let me see here. Oh, yeah, John Malkins at peoplescongress.org. Thank you, John. The message for Mike and all he's done to keep America on its toes, join the conversation to transform America's government at peoplescongress.org. I haven't mentioned them a lot recently, but you need to check out their website, peoplescongress.org, peoplescongress.org. Please do that. I mean, just go there and check it out. Just you know, whatever you decide to do once you're there is up to you. But go to the website, peoplescongress.org. And thanks to John Malkins for the sponsorship this first hour. Thanks, John. Mitt Romney, what? I cannot, you know, I can't look at the mister anymore without laughing. Condescendingly and patronizingly. Laughing. This guy really thinks he has a chance of becoming president. And you know what makes this so much fun? The right wingers are eating their own appendages because they can't stand the mister either. Even though he talks the talk of these right-wing doofuses, he doesn't walk the walk, and he never has. It's just not Mitt's style. Mitt is not a neoconservative, gagging, mind-blowing half-wit, even though he's trying to play one on TV so that he can get the base of the Republican Party to nominate him, which they effectively have done. Because if there's anything the base of the Republican Party likes, it's a mind-numbing, half-wit, drooling, right-wing troglodyte who walks around talking about all the stuff that these freaks like to hear. So Mitt's going to get the nomination. There's no question. Rick Santorum, you can wait till 2016 and get your ass handed to you. Again, if you want to. I mean, it's up to you, pal. But what cracks me up is watching the right-wingers choke on Mitt Romney. I love this. I think this is just fantastic. I absolutely love it. Now, when we come back, I'm going to tell you where the Mitster gets his information, his news and information. Stay with us. I'm Mike Malloy.